There are 514 cases of coronavirus, all locally acquired. That means we now have 4,370 active cases across Victoria. 148 of today's cases are linked to known outbreaks, and the balance are obviously under investigation by our public health team. There are three new cases in Ballarat, taking the total active cases there to six, with more expected in coming days. So that, I think, just confirms that there was and remains a significant challenge in Ballarat. 69.2% of Victorians aged between 16 and over, they have been first dosed. That is to say, 69.2% of Victorians have received a first dose of the eligible cohort. That means that tonight and into tomorrow, we will tip over that 70% first dose mark, that gateway. That's incredibly important, and of course we're going to keep going to get to 70% double dosed, and indeed 80% and above double dosed over the journey. The fact of the matter is that somewhere across the state today, someone will get the first dose, and they will tip us over that 70% mark. That's fantastic. Tipping over the 70% first dose mark, as we will, means that we can honour and indeed exceed the commitments that we had made to the Victorian community, particularly in metropolitan Melbourne, just a couple of weeks ago. But I've got a list here which I will run through of the things that change from 11:59 p.m. tomorrow night. So firstly, there are five reasons to leave the home at the moment. There will, from midnight tomorrow night, be a sixth, and that is for outdoor social interaction. We know that this is what the community is craving, the notion of being able to see people that they love and care for, the notion of being able to visit with other people. That has to be done safely. And that's why the Chief Health Officer has recommended, and Cabinet has endorsed, that for this new category of outdoor social interaction, one person may meet with another person, not from their household, for a picnic or another outdoor activity, regardless of whether they are vaccinated. Those who are fully vaccinated can meet in a group of up to five adults, plus their dependents, from as many as two households. So if you're not vaccinated or you only have one dose, you can, as a group of two, go outside and have that social interaction outdoors. If you're fully vaccinated, that number goes from two to five, but it is a maximum of two households. So we will see from 11:59 p.m. tomorrow night, so into the weekend, we'll see groups of people outside enjoying each other's company in a safe way. The groups are larger if you're vaccinated fully, because there's protection that comes from being fully vaccinated. If you're not vaccinated, by logic tells you, and the Chief Health Officer has confirmed, that group needs to be smaller. It needs to be just the two people. This is what Victorians have craved for a long time, and we're pleased to be able to take these modest, but I think significant, steps to provide this outdoor social interaction. It needs to be done safely. It needs to be done carefully, but these are important steps for us to take today. The time permitted will double from 2 hours to 4 hours for both exercise as well as the outdoor social interaction. And the distance you can travel from your home doubles from 5 kilometres to 10. So those three steps are in line with what we had spoken about being able to deliver. In fact, they're indeed beyond what we had indicated we would deliver a couple of weeks ago. We're not overselling it. They are modest changes, but they are significant, and I'm sure people will avail themselves of those options that have been not safe and have been denied to the community for many weeks now. Just to go through the rest of the announcements as they relate to both metropolitan Melbourne but also regional Victoria. Two people will now be able to train outdoors with a personal trainer. Skate parks and outdoor communal exercise equipment will also reopen. Childminding for school-aged children, so that's in-home childminding. Some of those, I think they've been described many times as a grandparent-type arrangement. That'll be extended at the moment. It's only for households where there are two authorised workers. It'll now be for households where there is just one authorised worker. Up to five people will be able to attend an entertainment venue or physical recreation facility for the purposes of broadcast of either a performance, a class, or a concert. Real estate inspections will resume by appointment only. The property would need to be vacant at the time of the inspection. The agent will stay outside. The prospective tenants or those who are seeking to purchase the home, they will be able to move through the home and inspect it. The residents there can't be at home. It doesn't have to be a vacant property, but for the time that the inspection's going on, they need to vacate. They need to move out for that hour or however long it takes. Limited and with COVID-safe rules, I'm sure the real estate industry and all of those who either want to get into the market or are looking to sell or have new tenants move into their property will be very appreciative of those changes. And we'll have a conversation, as we always do, with that sector to make sure they fully understand what those rules mean.